Hello everyone, my name is Zoofluencer and welcome to a new episode of Monkey Island. This time we are building an indoor habitat for the Japanese macaque. This is the very first habitat or the very first indoor habitat I ever created, so also the very first indoor habitat in Monkey Island. I created this indoor habitat because the monkeys are from a completely different region than where this zoo is based, and it seemed a bit unethical to keep these animals in a tropical region while they are used to temperatures below 0 degrees Celsius. So I decided to create a huge glass building, and instead of creating a rainforest in a colder region, I made it like a winter dome in a tropical region, especially made for these monkeys. Since this is already episode 7 of Monkey Island, make sure you also check out the other speed build videos of this series and subscribe to my channel right now if you don't want to miss out on any future episodes of this series, since it's really starting to become a beautiful looking island zoo. So the glass dome that I'm building right now was actually inspired by the rainforest dome in Singapore Gardens by the Bay. I know it looks completely different, but my building skills are not that good yet. I'm trying to improve it by creating more and more buildings to get my skills up to date, but it's starting to look really good. I know it's overlapping a bit right now, and I'm trying to fix that, and later I will just let it blend in with the terrain, with all the rocks, and you won't see it at all. Also, while I'm building this dome, I wanted to talk to you guys about my schedule of uploading different videos. Right now I started on two different series. So I got my Borealis Zoo in the Arctic region, and we got this series. And I'm also thinking about creating a new series in a franchise zoo. So saying all this, it's really a lot of work to create a video like this. Building a habitat like this takes me around 8 to 10 hours, and then another hour to do the video editing, and then it takes me like another 30 minutes to 1 hour to create this commentary. So you can imagine that combining this with a full-time job is quite a lot of work. So I decided to be uploading maybe twice or three times a week maximum. This will be, I think, the fourth video of this week, since I had a little bit more time this week. But in the future I will probably upload a Borealis Zoo video once a week and a Monkey Island video maybe once or twice a week. Right now I'm trying to blend in the guest paths with the environment and doing the pathing in the dome itself. I was messing around with the paths, trying to make it look good. I was thinking about a elevated path, but yeah, it didn't really look that good, so I ended up with these two small circular viewing platforms. And I also decided to make the terrain a little bit lower so the guests would have a proper view of the animals from the viewing platforms. So the guests will be separated by glass from the animals. I did read a lot about Japanese macaques escaping from their habitat, so I wanted to make sure that that wouldn't happen. Also, I moved the dome that I built from the habitat, and later on I will put it back, but it's much easier. If you are ever building an indoor habitat, it's much easier to do it like this, because yeah, it's horrible when you're working inside a dome. Your camera will get out and you have to try to get in the building again, and it's just horrible. So that's why I decided to do it a little bit different. So later on you will see me putting the dome back on the habitat and make sure that it blends in really well with the environment. So So, you will see that this commentary is a little bit longer than my previous videos, and that's also one thing I wanted to talk about. I got really different feedback from my videos. Some people do like it that there's a lot of music underneath the videos and a little bit less commentary, and some other people would say, okay, I really like the commentary, I would like to know why you were building this or how you're doing it. So I would really like to know what you guys think. Let me know in the comment section. I also did it a little bit different in a previous video of the orangutan habitat. Make sure you check out this video as well. I will put a link in the description. I did the commentary a little bit different, and also this time it's a bit different as well, a little bit longer than if you check out my first videos. It was like 30 seconds, and right now I think it will be 5 to 10 minutes of full commentary on this video. Also, another thing was that the volumes weren't really right, so hopefully it will get better in this video. I tried to increase the volume of the voice a bit, and will be decreasing the volume of the music in the end, because I don't want to hurt your ears when we switch from the voice commentary back to the beautiful soundtrack of Planet Zoo. So please let me know if that's getting better already. So as you can see, I just placed the dome back. Somehow I placed it back a little bit different from than it was before, so I had to make some adjustments on the terrain. And if you take a good look, you did see that my game crashed while I was building this. So I think it was like 30 minutes of gameplay that was lost. So I already moved around this lake, I already did all the terrain work, but then the game crashed and I had to do it all over again. But it ended up quite alright. Actually, the game crashed while I was putting in a staff door in this habitat. You will see me doing that later, and you might be seeing me saving the game 3 times before I do it again. So, but in the end it worked and it didn't crash anymore, and I did all the terrain work again. Also, these monkeys needed quite a bit of snow, and I didn't really like the view of the artificial snow in the game, and it didn't really fit into Monkey Island for me. And also because, yeah, everyone is building a tundra zoo at the moment, I didn't want to make it look too wintery, too much like a winter, or not too much snow. So I decided to put the snow only besides the rocks, and it looked really, really well. Normally, when you see temperatures outside of like 1 or 2 degrees, you would see that the snow would melt in open areas, but in the shade of the rocks or with the temperatures of the rocks, it would only stay there. So yeah, I decided to make it look like that, and it ended up really, really well. So right now the indoor habitat is actually almost finished, and the rest of the video will be mostly about me blending in the building with the rest of the tropical environment. It ends up quite nicely because you will see a rainforest looking dome, but actually on the inside it's winter, it's -4 degrees, so the guests will be cold, but there will be a lot of rock work, a lot of terrain work going on around the building. Also, make sure you check out the end of the video. There will be a cinematic reveal of the entire habitat. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button, and please leave a comment if you have any suggestions, tips, or whatever. If you want to say anything about this video, leave it in the comment section, and make sure you subscribe to my channel and enjoy the rest of the video. Goodbye.
Nispona se la pa se zowaka. Nispona se la pa se zowaka.